Hi, hello. Welcome back to this video lecture series on shear force and bending moment diagrams in mechanics of materials. So here you have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram for the given beam as shown in figure. So now this beam consists of point loads, that is 70 kN, 40 kN, and we have supports at B and D. And this beam is also subjected to a couple of 100 kN at A, but also 150 kN at C, in addition to uniformly distributed load of 10 kN/m. So most of the time these salient points will not be given, so we have to mark with our convenience. So here this is A, B, C, D are the salient points. Now, since it is simply supported beam, first of all we have to find out support reactions. So here supports are at B and D. So I have to find out support reaction RB and RD. So for that one, again we have to use that static equilibrium conditions or equations. So that conditions we know, that is sum of all the moments about any point must be equal to zero. That is sum of all the clockwise and counterclockwise moments about any point must be equal to zero. And one more is that sum of the upward forces must be equal to sum of the downward forces. So now to find out support reaction, I have taken a D about which I have considered moments. So sum of all the moments about D is equated to zero. With that, what are all that? So here I have told you, while finding out support reactions, if we take clockwise positive, counterclockwise should be considered as negative. If we take counterclockwise positive, clockwise negative. So what are all that clockwise and counterclockwise moments that we have here? This causes, that is 70. 70 into this distance, that is nothing but 8. So 70 into 8, so that is nothing but counterclockwise moment. So that is taken as negative. So then this is clockwise moment, that should be considered as, that couple should be taken as positive. Therefore, here it is taken as plus 100. Next, here the support reaction causes moment about point D in clockwise direction. So therefore, that is RB into 6, that is plus RB into 6. Then we have this couple is nothing but again clockwise. So clockwise has been taken as positive, therefore plus 150. Then because of this point load also will have moment that causes counterclockwise moment about D, that is minus 40 into 3. That is minus 40 into 3. Now we are left with uniformly distributed load of 10 kN per meter or length of 6 meters. So therefore, that 10 into 6 is the total load that will act as a point load at the center. Whenever we have uniformly distributed load, first that must be converted into point load by multiplying the given per meter length load with that distance. That will give that total load which will be acting at the center, that is 10 into 6, and it will be acting at the center, moment is nothing but into 3. So that is 10 into 6 into 3. So if we equate this with 0, we'll get the value of support reaction RP as 101.67 kN and RD. So second boundary condition, second equilibrium equation, sum of the upward forces, that is RP plus RD, must be equal to sum of the downward forces. While considering downward forces, we should not take that couple into account. So now this is downward force 70 plus 40 plus 10 into 6, 60. So that total is 170. So RP plus RD is equal to 170. So for known value of RP, we will get RD as 68.33 kN. So that is the first step in this simply supported beams. That is support reactions we have to find out. Once we get that, we can draw that shear force diagram. Either we can mark all that shear forces here, and directly marking here we can draw that shear force diagram, or else by considering that sign convention. What is that? After the loads, after all the loads, before this support D, I'll assume a section very close to this. So if I consider a section here, I don't have to draw that section. I assume a section very close to this. Then here this 100 kilonewton meter is nothing but couple. So that need not be considered while drawing, considering or while drawing shear force diagram. So then we have 70 kilonewton, that is downward. That is left downward is negative as per shear force convention. So with reference to this reference line taken, 70 kilonewton down we have to mark. And from here to here, there is no other load. Therefore, we can draw that horizontal constant line up to here. Now at B, we have support reaction of that calculated value. What is that we have calculated? 101.3. So from here to here, 101.7. So from it has to, since it is left upward is positive. Therefore, from this point, it has to go up by 101.7. So from here to here, it is 70. Another 31.7. Total from here to here, it is 101.7. Now we have UDL up to point C. So because of UDL, contribution due to that UDL at this point is zero, and it varies with the distance. So now here this UDL is 10 kilonewton per meter. For a span of 3 meters, it is 30. Since it is left downward is negative. Therefore, from this point, it has to come down by 30. So 31.7 minus 30 means 1.7. So here at point C, it should come down by 30. So we'll be left with 1.7 because left downward is negative. Now at point C, we have point load of 40 kilonewton. I told you while drawing that shear force diagram, we should not consider that couple. So here 40 kilonewton, that is left downward is positive. From this point, we have to draw 40 down. So that means 1.7 already there. So remaining will be 38.3 up here. Total will be 40. So now from point C to D, I have uniformly distributed load of 10 kilonewton per meter. So at this point, due to that UDL, contribution of load is zero. But when it comes to this point, 10 into 330, then again it is left downward negative. So from this point, another 30, it has to come down. Already here 38.3 is there. So the another 30 down means when it comes to this point, it will be 68.3 or 68.33 kilonewton. So this is shear force diagram. Now for completion's sake, if you want, we can mark that forces at different points. Shear force at D, we can easily make out, since it is, what is that one? We have calculated shear force at B is nothing but, shear force at D is nothing but 68.33. Okay, that is since it is below minus 68.33. So then at point C, so the resultant effect of those two forces will be 1.67 kilonewton. So this is minus 38.33 and plus 40, that resultant effect will be 1.67 kilonewton. Similarly, at different points, okay, at point B, it is nothing but resultant effect of 31.67 and 101.67. So here, total is nothing but 101.67 or 101.7. So in that, this is positive, this is negative. So we will get that as 70 kilonewton. That is nothing but minus 70. Of course, at this point A, we have minus 70 kilonewton. So these things, if you want, we can mark. Now we have to find out bending moments at different points. So to find out bending moment, when there is no couple, end couple, then bending moment at D is zero. So then what is the bending moment at A? But if this couple would not have been there, then there also bending moment at A should have been taken as zero. But since that 100 kilonewton is there, and again before the support, left clockwise is positive, that is left clockwise is positive 100 kilonewton meter, and that is bending moment at A. So then what is the bending moment at B? So bending moment at B will be again left clockwise, that is 100. This is minus 70 into 2. 70 into 2 is, since it is counterclockwise, minus 140 plus 100, that is minus 40. So bending moment at B will be minus 40 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at C. So again, assuming that section at the same phase, so this 100 kilonewton is positive left clockwise, then this 70 into this distance. So this distance is nothing but 5. 70 into 5 is 350, that is minus 350. Then in addition to that, we have uniformly distributed load of 10 kilonewton, that is 10 into 3 into 1.5. So if we simplify that, we will get bending moment at C as 10 kilonewton meter. Here we should not get confused. So here that directly bending moment at C has been calculated from this end. So because RD is nothing but 68.33. So this to this, what is that one? This section considered, that is right clockwise. Right clock, left clockwise is positive. Right counterclockwise. Right counterclockwise is positive. When left clockwise is positive, right counterclockwise is positive. To this section, that support reaction RD causes counterclockwise. That is at point C, that RD into this 3. RD is nothing but 68.33 into 3. And then we have uniformly distributed load, which causes clockwise. That is left clockwise. Here we have taken that section. So left, this causes again about bending moment. So we have to consider section here. So that becomes minus 10 into 3 into 1.5. And again, so right clockwise is negative, minus 150. With that also, we can get that bending moment at C. So if it is confusing, we can simply consider from one end only. That's what I explained in the beginning. So if we want to find out bending moment at C, so this 100 kilonewton meter, that is positive because left clockwise, then 70 into 5. 70 into 5 is 350, that is minus 350. Then minus 350 plus 100 will be minus 250. So in addition to that, we have UDL. UDL is nothing but, so that how much is that? 10 into 3 into 1.5. 10 into 3 is 30. 30 into 1.5 is 45. So 250 and 45. So if we consider that resultant effect, we will get that bending moment as 10 here. Okay, resultant of that one will be 10 at C. Of course, in addition to that, we have a couple of clockwise couple, a positive couple, that is 150. Therefore, 10 plus 150, 160. So now, by marking all those moments here, so here, as we know, this is positive 100. That is positive 100, that is marked. Here at point B, it is minus 40. Therefore, below that reference line, minus 40 is marked. So then bending moment, because of that loads and couple that are acting to the left or right of that one, by considering that, we get 10 here. Okay, 10 kilonewton. In addition to that, we have clockwise couple of 150. Left clockwise is positive. Therefore, another 150 gets added to this. So here it will be 160. And here bending moment at D is 0. So now we have to join these points. So this by line. And this is uniformly distributed load. Therefore, parabolic curve. So when we join this and this, at some point it will cross this line. Here also same thing. When we are joining this and this, at some point it crosses the bending moment diagram. The point where it crosses, or where the bending moment is zero, is known as point of contraflexure or point of interflexure. So point of contraflexure or point of inflexure is the point where the bending moment is zero in bending moment diagram. So here also it is zero, here also it is zero. Those points we have to locate. So then here to here, as I told you, it's a curve, and here also it is parabolic curve because of uniformly distributed load. Now I have to find out point of contraflexure or point of inflexure. So for that one, I have considered this simply support the given beam along with that bending moment diagram. So now let me call this. So it is known that from here to here it is nothing but 2. So now I'll call this distance from here to here as x. When I call this distance as x, then total distance from this end to this point is x plus 2. So this is the point of contraflexure. To find out that, let me project this onto that load diagram. When I project here, so this is the point where I have to find out bending moment. I'll call that point as xx. So bending moment at this point will be equal to that 100. 100 is left clockwise positive. Here also we have to consider sign convention for bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram, that is 100. So then this causes minus. So from here to here, it is nothing but x plus 2. Therefore, minus 70 into x plus 2. Then we have this RB that causes clockwise. RB is 101.67 into this distance. That distance is nothing but x. So 101.67 into x. So then we have UDL between this point. From this point and this point, we have uniformly distributed load of 10 kilonewton per meter, and that distance is nothing but x. So because from here to here, if it is x plus 2, then this has to be x. So that again causes 10 into x by 2. So that is counterclockwise, left counterclockwise is negative. Therefore, 10 minus 10 into x by 2, that must be equated to 0. So now if we simplify this quadratic equation, we'll get the value of x. Once we get the value of x, if we add 2 to that from the end A, we will get that point of contraflexure distance. So next, let us consider a numerical wherein we have all the types of loads. In the sense, we have point load, we have uniformly distributed load, we have uniformly varying load. Of course, this point load is acting at certain distance from here. So because of this distance, the couple or moment will act here. So that moment is nothing but 40 into 0.5, that is 20 kilonewton meter at point C, that causes clockwise moment. So in addition to that, by the characteristics of force, what are the characteristics of force? Magnitude, direction, and point of application. So because of that, this 40 kilonewton will be there at this point C. So in addition to moment of 20 kilonewton meter, we will have that point load of 40 kilonewton also at point C. Now, if we draw that equivalent diagram for this, so that's what I told you, this is UDL, and here this causes clockwise couple of 20 kilonewton meter, and again because of this, we have this point load of 40 kilonewton. So now, see again, this is simply supported. We need not bother about these rollers or fixed knife edge and all. So since it cannot move in this direction, reaction will be upwards. Therefore, if we mark that as A, B, C, D, E, salient point, I had to find out support reactions RA and RD. So to find out that one, apart from that triangular road, remaining procedure is same. So here, moments about A has been taken. Moment about A is equal to 0 means we have to consider all the moments, because of all that forces and whatever the moments are there, that also has to be taken into account. So now to start with, so here one by one, so it is taken from RD. Here we have I have taken it as RD. So for this one, RD into this distance, RD into this distance is nothing but 4. So this counterclockwise has been taken as negative, minus RD into 4. Then what is that we have? So here uniformly distributed load, because of that moment about A will be 20 into 2. 20 into 2 is the total load, and that will be acting at the center into 1. So therefore 20 into 2 into 1. Next, we have this point load that also passes clockwise. Therefore, plus 40 into this distance 3, plus 40 into 3. Because clockwise we are taking positive, counterclockwise negative. Then here we have clockwise moment of 20. Therefore, that also plus 20 we have to add. So in addition to that, while calculating moment due to the triangular load, we must be careful. In case of uniformly distributed load, we have taken that as 20 into 2. 20 into 2 is the total load that will be concentrated at the center of gravity, so which will be at a distance of half the height of this rectangle, at the middle of that rectangle. So if it is triangular load, same procedure, area of rectangle is B into H, whereas in case of triangle, area of triangle is half base into height, half base. Base is taken as 2, or base, if you want, you can take this as 30 into height 2, half base into height. That area that will be concentrating at center of gravity. For a triangle, from the base it is h by 3, from the corner it is 2h by 3. Since I am taking moments about this point A, I want center of gravity from this base, that is at a distance of h by 3. So h is nothing but how much? H is nothing but 2, 2 by 3. And since I am taking moment about that, so half into base, 30 into 2 into h by 3 is from here to here, that is 2 by 3. And since moment is required up to here, plus 4 I have to take. 4 plus h by 3, 2 by 3. This step is very important. So if we equate to that to 0, we will get one support reaction, RD. RD is equal to 80 kN. Now, to find out another support reaction, upward force RA plus RD must be equal to total downward force as. Downward force here is 20 into 2. We should not take 20 into 2 into 1. This is not moment. So for force, it is 20 into 2. And while considering force, we should not consider this couple. So plus 40, that is also acting downward, plus area of this triangle. As I told you, area of this triangle is the total load that is acting downwards through its center of gravity. So what is that load? Half into 30 into 2. So all that RA plus RB, RA plus RD is equal to total downward force. With that, I'll get RA as 30 kN. So once I get that one, I can draw shear force diagram, and also I can draw bending moment diagrams. So to find out that shear force and bending moment diagrams, of course different notations are used here. So what is that shear force at support, at this support? What is the shear force at this point? What is the shear force? So those things we can mark in our own way. So that is what shear force at A, B, C, D and other things. So once we mark that one, we can draw shear force diagram. So even after drawing this one, we can mark those shear forces. Now before support, so here one support is there, here one support is there. After the loads and before support, if I assume a section here, so this is left upward positive, RA is positive, therefore from reference line, the 30 has been marked. Now we have uniformly distributed load of 20 kilonewton per meter over that length 2. So therefore 20 into 2 is the total load, and we are considering only that load. And of course here the 30 we have marked, and here starting due to the contribution due to UDL is 0, and whereas here 20 into 2 40, so that is left downward is negative. From this 30 it will come down by 40, so that means already 30 is there, another 10 at this point, so we have to join this to this. This total distance now is 40. Now from here to here there is no other road, therefore we have to join by line. Now another 40 is acting downwards, left downward is negative. From this point another 40 will go down, total it will be minus 50 here. So this is constant up to here. Then what is that RD? RD is 80 kilonewton. So that is right upward. Left upward is positive, therefore right upward is negative. So therefore here already 50 it has come down. So total it has to come down by 80. So 50 means another 30 above if we mark. From this point it is coming down by 80. So now here there is no load, therefore it is zero. And most important thing here is, in shear force diagram also we will have that parabolic curve in case of triangular load, because here half base into height, so here we will get quadratic relation into half base into height, okay, for moment into distance about center of gravity. So because of that quadratic relation we will get a parabolic curve, whereas in case of uniformly distributed load it is linear line, because it is F into L into L by 2. So it is only this thing, YF, directly proportional to that length. So here square of that one, therefore it is a parabolic curve. So now bending moments at different points we have to find out. End moments, bending moment at A is 0, bending moment at E is 0. Then bending moment, okay, no need to find out at section and all those things. Bending moment at B, directly we can find out. So again section is considered here. So this RB into this distance, RB into distance is how much? 2. RB into 2, that is left clockwise positive, minus 20 into 2 into 1, because left counterclockwise, therefore minus 20 into 2 into 1. We'll get it as positive 20 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at C, that is again left clockwise positive, RA into 3, that is 30 into 3 minus 20 into 2 into, we should not take simply 1. Since we are taking up to here, here 1 plus 1, that is 2. Therefore, that is minus 20 into 2 into 2 by 2 plus 1, or into 2 directly we can write. That is 10 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at C, of course, in addition to this moment, moment due to this point load, we have that couple. But by diagram, we have to show that separately. So while drawing that one, I'll explain. Now bending moment at D, we have to find out same procedure. That is RA. RA, that is positive, into that 4 minus 20 into 2 into 2 by 2 is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3, minus 40 into 1, this plus, because couple we have to take, that is left clockwise is positive plus 20. So if you simplify, we get bending moment at D. So even if we want, we can consider from right side, finding out bending moment here. So this is nothing but half base into height. It will be acting at a distance of h by 3 from here. Therefore, into that 2 by 3. So that is what is done here. So likewise also you can do, but answer will not vary. Either considering all the forces and moments acting to the left of that, or by considering all the forces and moments acting to the right of that, you will get the same value. Now once we have those values, by marking those and joining by the respective line or curve, we'll get the bending moment diagram. So here, since it is UDL, we have to join this by curve. Whereas here, this must be joined by line. Here also line, here also line open. Whereas here, we have triangular load. For triangular load, shear force diagram itself is a curve, parabolic curve. So here it is a cubic parabola. So therefore, this is also a curve. So now this is bending moment diagram for the given beam. And one important thing here is, there is one point where bending moment is changing its sign at this point. The point where the bending moment is zero, or the point where bending moment changes its sign in bending moment diagram, is point of contraflexure or point of inflexure. That we have to find out. For that one, we can consider either from the left side or from the right side. Now, so this is the point of contraflexure that we can find out. Before finding out that point of contraflexure, I forget to tell you one thing. Whenever that shear force is zero in shear force diagram, that point we call it as point of maximum bending moment. So out of all that bending moments, what we are drawing here, the bending moment will be maximum where shear force is zero. Now to find out that maximum bending moment, just to project this onto the load line and consider at this point force is zero. So let me call this distance from here to here as x. So x, after calculating only, I have written as 1.5 meter. So before that, let me call this as x. So at that point, fx is equal to zero. So what are all the forces that are acting to the left or right of that? Let me consider the forces acting to the left of that form. So when fx is equal to zero, Ra, left upward is positive, that is Ra 30. This left downward is negative, minus 20. Since it is UDL, so distance is taken as x, minus 20 into x. I repeat, at this point, if we call this, when we produce, project this into load line, and if we call this distance as x, at this point fx is zero, then what are the forces acting to the left of that one? Ra, that is 30, left upward positive, minus 20 into x must be equal to zero. With that, x is equal to 30 by 20, that is 1.5 meters we'll get. After getting that x value, we can find out maximum bending moment. Same point, take moments about this. So Ra into x, Ra into x is nothing but left clockwise positive, minus 20 into x by 2. Ra into x, minus 20 into x by 2. That is nothing but bending moment at this point, mx. So there, if we substitute the value of x, we'll get maximum bending moment. So that's very important. Earlier, I forget to tell that. Now, coming back to this point of contraflexure. So point of contraflexure, we have to find out similar to previous problems. So that is, let me call this distance from here to this support, I'll call this distance as x. So then mx or mp, or if you call this distance as, say, from this to this, y, to avoid confusion, as we have already taken x, let me take this distance as y. So when I project this here, let me call that point as p. So point of contraflexure mp. So at point of mp, bending moment is zero. So then what are the moments? Ra into y, left clockwise is positive, Ra into y, minus 20 into 2, minus 20 into 2. Say up to here I have to take, the total distance is y, in that 1 I have to subtract. Therefore y minus 1. I repeat, because of UDL, moment about this point, P, point of contraflexure, is minus 20 into 2 into that distance will be, since it is acting at the center, from here to here it is y minus 1 we have to take. Similarly, we have to consider moment because of this 40 that causes counterclockwise. minus 40 into this distance from here to here, it is y. So y minus 3, 40 minus y minus 40 into y minus 3. In addition to that, we have clockwise couple plus 20, and that must be equated to 0. With that, we'll get the value of y. So similar to previous problems, get the value of y, that is point of contraflexure. Okay.